Hello everybody, this is Little Neenja and welcome back to the 10th episode of Neenja's Empire. In the last episode we built this house. Yeah. And it's not, you know, too bad, but there are some details that it could definitely use, and maybe some things like I think in the end of the last episode I discussed doing this for shutters. And yes, that definitely looks better. So I'm gonna do those on the windows, and then maybe a flower here or there, just to kind of break up the bare stone wall. Oh, and I need to plant a tree here somewhere. And the interior could use a little bit of work right now, but today I want to focus on some redstone. For those of you who don't know, this house is a recreation of a house, of the first house I ever built, and the basement was kind of tricked out. And so the first thing I need to do is build a hidden staircase, and it was on this side of the house, and I'm not quite sure how I'm going to do this yet. I'll play around with some designs and show you what I decide when I do so. And yeah, so I'll go ahead and finish decorating the outside of this and then put that staircase in. Right, so the outside of the house is a little spruced up and looking much better. And now the redstone is being a little bit of a problem. So this is the block swap, so like it takes the floor out and replaces it with a stair, and then you can walk down like this. But there's other pistons behind these blocks right here that need to be powered when this piston is powered, and it doesn't work to run redstone under them. Yeah, I'm not very good at redstone. What I'm going to do is take out this dirt and run the redstone on top of a block behind the pistons, and then just raise the ground level here a little bit so it'll all be hidden. I mean, yeah, it'll make the outside wall of the house look a little less ginormous and stark, and yeah, that'll be the simplest fix, I think. And then once that's done, we can start work on the basement area down here. And that seems to function. So yeah, it'll be perfectly hidden now once I replace this wall. Now all I have to do is power this block like this. Yep, it works. Perfect. So the next thing in line is a coated lava trap down here. This place isn't only hidden, it's also locked with codes and stuff. And the first time I built it, it only took like, you know, a week or a month, or I can't remember how long, but it was a really long time. Hopefully it won't take that long this time, if I can remember how to build it, which I have no idea if I can. But I'm going to get started and open up this area down here and see if I can remember. So this is the basic principle of the thing. The floor is trapdoors, and underneath here will be lava when I'm done setting it up. And then the ceiling is buttons, and one of these six buttons opens that door, and all the others open the trapdoors. So now I've got to figure out how to hook these buttons, five of them up to all the trapdoors simultaneously, and one of them up to only that door. So yeah, it's going to take a little bit of trial and error, but it shouldn't be too hard. And then after that, we'll do like a lever, a panel of levers that all have to be at the right position in order to open the second door. And then behind that will be like a vault or whatever. Right, I think I've got it working. All five buttons work and open all the doors. And yeah, once there's lava in here, we won't want to be doing this. But this button doesn't open the trapdoors. Now all we have to do is hook up this block to this door. I think if we run a repeater out here, then we can run redstone around to the door. Yeah. Right, so I have to go craft a repeater, and then that should be that section done. We can cover up all this hole and then move on to the next section. So I hooked it up and closed it all up, and now these five buttons open the trapdoors, and this one opens the iron door. Perfect. And now we can put a lever in here and hook it up to the trapdoors as well, so that when you're in here, you can have the option of locking the trapdoors open so that nobody can follow you in. And Yeah, so the lever will need to go, let's see, if I can put it on this wall and run it through that redstone. Okay, and then put a button here so that we can open the door from this side as well. And then I'll do another staircase going down because, well, we're kind of close to that's the floor of the house. So I've got to fill this in with lava and hook up this lever and put a button in here, and then we can move on to the next door. So I just discovered a secret that is rather amusing, but if you don't tell, I won't. I'm telling you right now. But yeah, when the trapdoors are open, you can just walk on them like this because, you know, ninja. But oh well. I'm actually going to break this because I'm scared I'm going to, like, you know, fall off the edge. It would be classic me to just walk right off the edge. Right, so it goes like this. And then that trapdoor the lever locks the trapdoors open when you're in here working on all your secret stuff. So now I'm going to make a little staircase that goes down through here, and then we can do the panel of levers. You remember how there's a lever down there that locks the trapdoors open above the lava and stuff? Yeah, I opened it and I was down there digging out the space for the the staircase that goes down to the second door, and I needed something, and I came charging up out of here, and of course, you know, fell straight into the lava. Classic me. And I lost a bunch of stuff, including my good pickaxe. I have two more, but they're both almost broken, so I'm gonna have to make a run to the Blaze Farm to repair them before I do any more work down here. So yeah, that's gonna take a bunch of time, actually. Man, these critters are loud. And I think my pulse extender up there is messed up because they are not one-hit kill, which is a problem. I'm gonna have to come back here sometime when I have time and fix that. But for now, we just have to swing a couple of times to get them all dead. So, yep, we gotta finish repairing this pick and then repair this one as well. And then we'll go back and finish up the basement in the house. Well, it's done. The picks are both repaired. And, I mean, this thing is fast. It's faster than just gathering XP somewhere else, like on a normal, like a zombie spawner or something. But it's still just not really that fast. And I think at some point I want to do an AFK gold farm. Gold/XP farm. Go up to the roof of the Nether and build a donut farm for pigmen. But now I didn't get any food when I came over here, and now my hunger is way down there, and I can't sprint, so I'm gonna have to walk at this just foot dragging pace all the way back to the portal. Fun times. So at last I got my stuff together and did a little more work down here, and I thought, what better material to build a vault with than iron? And so I got all the iron I could find and used it up. And the reason there's so much glowstone in here is because I didn't actually have enough to cover the floor, so that'll be glowstone. And I still need to do the walls and ceiling out here, but now the redstone, I'm going to have a panel like this with 8 switches, and they're all going to have to be in the right position, you know, something like that, in order for the door to open. And the way to do this is to actually have the door open. That way, when it's actually, it should be the other way. No, I don't think it matters. So, like, if you power this block, the door should close. Or maybe power the block under it. That's what I'll do. Anyway, then you go behind here, and you take outputs from these blocks, and the, you know, certain levers, you invert the signal, the redstone signal. So all of the levers have to be turned off, or the inverted ones on, in order for the door to open. And then you come in here and you put your diamonds and redstone and whatever else in there. And then, yeah, so I got to hook up the redstone behind these levers and finish up this hallway, and then we can move on to the next project. So this is the code, and it's pretty straightforward redstone. So, like, if any of these are in the wrong position, the door will stay shut. But now I have to hook up these three switches to the door, and it's proving to be a bit of a problem how to get a redstone output out of this block. I'm gonna have to think about this one for a while. I think I came up with a solution, and it's actually fairly simple, although not exactly resource friendly, which I guess none of this build really is. If we do this, then that should still power the redstone below it, and yes it does, and then we can put sticky pistons on the back of these blocks, and they should power when we flick this switch. It does, and let's see here. Redstone like that, and then run a line along here, and in there. Perfect. Now, if any of these switches are in a different position, it should close the door, which it does. Awesome. So now we switch them all to the same position, and try to remember that as best we can. And now I've got to clean up this hallway, and I'll probably just do, you know, plain old stone brick through here, and a couple torches or something, light it up more, and then we can go on to the next thing. And I have finished, and this project was a lot of fun. I built the original house probably close to 4 years ago, and so it was a bit of a trick remembering how I did everything, but this should work absolutely perfectly. And I'm either going to stand on the edge here in case I hit the wrong button, because that would be very characteristic. And that works. And now, let's see if I can actually remember the code. So it was like this, I think. Perfect. The door opens. Right. So we can lock that again and go on to the next project. And there's actually two things that I want to do. One of them is I need leather to finish this map. And well, for the item frames, and so I want to build a cow farm, but I'm not quite sure on what design I want to go with. And the other thing is, well, obviously I just used up all the iron I had on that build, and so what I want to do is make another iron farm way up in the sky. So the villages, I've been looking into a little bit, and I actually play on a whitelisted server quite a bit, and I did this on there, but villages, when they're 66 blocks apart from center to center of the village, they don't merge. So if I go from this farm 66 blocks up, I can build a second farm and then have the iron golems drop straight the way down, all the way down to this lava down here, and we will get twice the drops from this. So yeah, I mean, that really shouldn't be too hard. Probably the trickiest thing will be to get the villagers up there once the farm is built. But I need to empty out my inventory of all this redstone and get a bunch of wood and then go up there and start work. Right. So since the doors are on the same level, the center of the village is pretty predictable. So if we go from the block above the doors to the block above the doors up there and just go 67 blocks just to be safe, we should be good. So I've got to make a ginormous pillar in the sky, and I'm already thinking about how in the world I'm going to disguise this thing. Like, should I turn it into an airship, or should I take this tower on up 66 blocks? I mean, that is a high tower, like seriously high tower. But yeah, I mean, I'm just going to build it right now, and we'll cross that bridge when we get there. So I just got up here and built the ring that goes directly on top of the doors. And look at this view. It's incredible. The compound, or the empire, looks absolutely tiny from up here. I mean, that is a mega roof, and it's just tiny. This place is huge, and it looks like nothing. It looks like a small courtyard from up here. So I think probably airship would be the way to go, and not tower, because that would look more like a toothpick and less like a skyscraper at this height with this diameter. So yeah, it's a little bit of grindy work right now. Just going to have to see if I can place ladders going downwards and try not to fall, and then build the layer under it. And there's a layer that goes right here, I think, or maybe one block down. I'll have to look back and see how these things are built again, because I kind of forget. But yeah, it shouldn't be too hard. Shouldn't take long at all to finish this thing up, and then we will get twice the amount of iron drops down there. which will be absolutely awesome. So the first platform is done, and I did this one a little bit differently than I did the one down there. I read on the Reddit, I don't know if it's true, but I read that iron golems actually need a space of 4 blocks high to spawn in, not just 3. So I moved this platform down a layer from where the top platform will be. I don't really know if that's true or not, but it won't hurt to do that. It might improve the efficiency of the farm. And I just died. Yay. Right. So I hit control instead of shift, and so instead of let me just turn it into day. Instead of stopping at the edge of the platform, I literally sprinted off of it. So that was not my brightest moment. If I can get out this door, there we go. I'll go back up there and collect all my stuff. Probably half of it is in the iron farm, and oh, it's gonna be spread everywhere, isn't it? Oh, this is a mess. Guys, I seem to have lost my pick, and also a second bucket of water, and I picked up an oakwood slab from I have no idea where. This is a real problem. Like, okay, so there was some stuff in the chest down there. There was a bunch of stuff up here on top of this wall, and there were a few things down here, but my pick, the second really good pick that I lost in this episode, I'm not particularly thrilled right now, and I've fallen in a hole. Oh boy, I hope I can find that thing before it despawns. This is bad. This is not good. It's just gone. It's not here. It's not down there. It's not between any of the chests. It's not in the iron farm. It's not up here. It's not outside. It's gone. It just completely vanished off the face of the earth, and I am extremely unhappy about it. Like, what even? Picks don't just disappear into thin air. That doesn't happen. Like, one pick and one bucket of water, and there may have been some wood, but I don't think so. Like, it vanished. It literally just vanished. I'm so confused right now. And also rather annoyed. What in the world could have happened to it? And I've fallen down again. Well, I'll look around here then. It's just not anywhere to be found. So random. So after 5 minutes of searching, I still couldn't find my pick, and I decided not to bellyache about it. I went on up there and I finished the structure of the farm. And now what I'm doing is, we have a ton of powered rails left over from when we built the slime farm and thought that, I built the slime farm and I thought that I was going to need way more powered rails than what I actually did. And so, yeah, that's how I'm going to bring them out. I'm going to extract them the same way that we did to put the villagers in those farms over there. And then I'll just run them up the minecart rail up to there, and 2 villagers go on each side of the farm, and then they breed a couple times. I think you have to have 10 villagers before a golem will spawn, but as soon as there's 2 villagers in each pod, they'll breed themselves, and there will soon be enough for golems to spawn, and then we'll get our farm drop rates doubled, which is absolutely awesome. So this is the ejection track for the villagers, and it normally goes around that way, and now it will come out this way and go up through here and up that way, and the entire rail is set up and powered. And so now all that should be left to do is to run this down here and put in some power. Whoops, that's the wrong spot. Put in some power, there we go, and let's see here, come on, reach, it doesn't quite reach, oh well, we'll just put some non-powered rail in there, and of course it goes over to that. Let's see here, please work, just function, there, perfect. Now, Any villager that we eject out of the villager trading center will go flying up there and straight into the iron farm up top. So let's see here, which one? Here's a nitwit. Get out of here. Right. So let's see if he makes it. There he goes. Good. Right. So I just have to do this with another villager and then move the top of the track over to, you know, that side and do it twice, and then that side and do it twice, and so on. So yep, I'll move all the villagers up there and then the farm should be basically completed. And the farm is finally done. The villagers are all in their pods and I'm just waiting for them to breed, because I think you need at least 10 villagers in order for iron golems to spawn. And I removed the minecart rail, and I remembered something that I was gonna say before I went flying off the corner of this thing and killed myself and lost my pickaxe. This bay right here lends itself really well to having a pier built and maybe a couple boats, fishing village, something like that in a future episode. This farm is done except for decoration, but that is going to have to wait for later because I'm all out of time for today. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you in the next one.